This calibration method refers to the process of measuring and adjusting the accuracy of a specified angle. In SteamInput's case, angle calibration is used as a way to calibrate the mouse input's camera pixels in either first-person or third-person camera by making one full 360 degrees. There are two ways we can calibrate the angle. So, let's start with the first method. We need to find a way to get the in-game camera controls to correspond within a 360-degree turn. For that, we can go to one of those two modes, gyro or flick stick. We're going to start by using gyro mode. We first need to check the in-game sensitivity settings, as it's going to affect the entire process. You can either use your preferred sensitivity scale or use the default scale. For consistency, I personally recommend using the default in-game sensitivity across all games. In order to calibrate the angle, we need to start by performing a table turning test. Now let's try to calibrate by rotating the controller. We have just overshoot it by rough estimate of around, I think it's around 150 to 180 degrees. Now let's go back to the settings and lower the sensitivity slider and see how this works now. Welp, it's still overshooting. So, let me try to set to 7045px and... That's weird. I already tested it much earlier. Oh, I forgot. We need to go back and change both gyro degree sensitivity and vertical slash horizontal output mixer. Just set them to both 1x and 0% respectively. Just keep that in mind next time. Now, let's try again. Close enough. But there could be rooms for improvement. Let's head over to the flick stick mode. Within flick stick mode, we can determine the angle of a camera rotation with much more accuracy. We can do this by either using the joystick or a trackpad. Using the work that was done from the gyro mode, we're able to consistently perform a full 360 degree turn. This process requires trial and error to get there. What I have shown thus far was the easiest way of calibrating the angle. What if we use a calculator? Thanks to the Reddit user, AdorablePotteryy, they wrote a guide on how to quickly configure the calibration of the flick stick. As the guide is a bit messy, I decided to clean it and make it much more easier to understand. For method number 2, I'm going to explain all of this, but in a video format. Open the web browser and head over to mousesensitivity.com and scroll down. What we'll need to do is to change the calculator settings and change the units to counts. Head over to the input and pick a game of your choice. We need to take the in-game mouse's sensitivity and place it on the calculator. We can do this by heading over to the in-game settings or find the INTI file and grab the value there. Don't forget to choose either your own mouse sensitivity or the default sensitivity slider. Depending on what sources you got it from, you need to make sure you select the location to either in-game or config file. We need to set the pixel numbers to the DPI. While you can take your own mouse's DPI as a basis, I personally recommend you take the SteamInput's default pixel values and treat it as a DPI. Now that you calculate it, just scroll down and you will see the results. According to our calculator, the 360 degrees distance is 1440 counts. Now copy-paste that number and manually edit the value of the angle per pixel slider. Depending on the game, we might have a slightly different result. If you see a count that has more than 4 numbers and you decide to apply to the same slider, SteamInput will only clamp the number down to just 4 or 5 numbers. To reduce redundancies, just copy-paste the first 4 or 5 digits. One more thing, this method will be entirely dependent on how the game implements the mouse's camera controls. There are some cases where you have been more involved with the calculator. either the resolution, the frame rate, the FOV slider, additional sensitivity scales, the enhanced pointer precision that is built to your operating system, and much more. This also applies to method number one. For SteamInput API support games that ships with a mouse-like camera action, this method does not work. This is because the camera sensitivity is entirely built into the configurator, so you may have to rely on manual calibration, although it is somewhat easier to do it there compared to legacy mouse. Whichever method you went with, we're able to achieve a near flawless 360 degree turn in both in-game and real-life controller. This should allow us to have a more consistent camera controlling experience across all supported input styles.